Welcome to Election Coverage 2004. We are here in the County Council Chamber in Lifford, the seat of power in Donegal. Here local councillors decide the future of Donegal and its people. You, the electorate, decide who represents you here. Before we take a look at what happened during the count, we would like to pay tribute to recently retired councillors.
13 wonderful years working for the people of Donegal, for people in the Letterkenny electoral area especially. I've enjoyed it tremendously. It's been a great experience. 13 years representing my town and the county. Two sessions in Letterkenny Town Council and one in the Senate for 4.5 years. It's been an education on its own and I've learned a lot from it.
I would have joined Donegal County Council on a very small incline as to how the council runs. Since I came into the council, I've learned a lot with the help of my own fellow members there in Fianna Fáil, and also with Minister Coughlin herself, because she would have given me a great insight as to how the council run. And I'm glad that I took the experience to see how it actually ran, and yeah, I enjoyed it very much.
I came into politics through the voluntary sector way back in June 97 when I stood as a community candidate for Dáil Éireann. And I was as surprised as the next when I was elected to the Dáil. It changed my lifestyle totally. I've had 7 years now, 5 in the Dáil and 5 in the council. Some of that time was simultaneous in each, but I enjoyed my time. It was hectic, it was busy, but I enjoyed it thoroughly.
I've mixed emotions. I don't think I have any regrets about the decision I made, because I waited up long and hard, and it was the most difficult decision I've had to make in my personal professional capacity, because politics embraces both your personal and your professional life, so it was the most difficult one to date. And having made it, I'm happy it's the right decision, but on a day like today, it's certainly mixed emotions, because I'm going to miss coming down to Lifford and miss the camaraderie that we've had here and just meeting with all the staff. It's a very friendly place at the end of the day.
You know, having done over 30 years, I think that once a person does over 30 years, you know, they should make way for younger people, and you'll probably miss a bit of cut and thrust of the happenings in the chamber, but I think we're lucky in having a very good council, and you know, I know there would always be a welcome for me if I wanted to come back over and sit in at the back of the chamber and see how things were going.
I feel grand. I feel relieved. Indeed, yeah. People said to me today, I must be emotional. I'm not a bit emotional. I've been around for 49 years, and the time has come to hand over to somebody else, and I'm just quite happy. I wrote the pacts for the last 30 years, and between Fine Gael and the Blaineys and ourselves, and we've always honoured it, and as a result we've had a pretty good relationship.
Before voting took place, our cameras went out to find a few predictions from party officials.
It'll be 30 years ago in next month that I first went for the council elections in June 1974. Actually, I wasn't elected, so if anyone is defeated, take heart, because inside 3 years I was elected to Dáil Éireann. So it is usually the first stepping stone for any budding politician. I'm sure in local elections, whereas national events impinge somewhat on people's voting patterns, I'm sure a lot of it is going to be the local issues in various areas, what people think of some candidates, etc., etc. So hopefully we're going to do reasonably well.
We're very confident about this election, and we believe that nationally Sinn Féin is going to be the story of the election, and in Donegal, Donegal is going to play its part in delivering a number of Sinn Féin councillors to Donegal County Council, and of course others will be elected to the urban and town commissions.
Well, we've started, a 42-day tour of all the constituencies today, and I'm very glad to be back again in Donegal for the second time in 3 weeks. And we're expecting a very strong and a very vigorous campaign in Donegal for the local elections. We believe that from the comments made around the country and from the support building up for Fine Gael through every constituency, that there is a lot of anti-government feeling out there. And we're really fighting a very vigorous campaign on the basis of building a platform so that we can strike for government inside 2.5 years.
Now it's time to take a look at what happened to your vote in your area.
Hanahan Francis Fianna Fáil plus 16, bringing up to a total of 1925, 1925. Doherty Albert plus 24, taking up to a total of 1368, 1368. Donahue Rina Fianna Fáil plus 20, taking up to a total of 1937. 1,937. McDonald Marion Fianna Fáil plus 269, up to a total of 1599, 1,599. McGonagall Dennis Fianna Fáil plus 33, up to a total of 1734, 1,734. McGinnis Bernard Fine Gael plus 349, taking up to a total of 2424, 2,424. Non-transferable papers not effective, 142. As the votes of Bernard McGinnis exceeds the quota, I deem him to be elected.
Excellent, absolutely fantastic result. I increased my vote by over 25% from the last time.
And what do you think you can base that on?
I suppose hard work and dedication to the job. And I've been councillor for the last 25 years, and I've built up a reputation of trying to do my best for people. It's not always possible, but you do what you can and as much as you can. It's difficult when you run the business, and it's difficult involved in other things, but. And it's nearly getting to be a full-time job.
You do take it personally because you've been out in the streets, you've pounded the streets, you've worked with them and you've tried your best to guide the election campaigns. And, you know, you just, as I say, always hope that it works out at the end. But no one, unless you're here at the count, understands how important their one vote is. And even at this point in time, their first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, even seventh preference at this stage has been so important. And while it might be lost in the electronic voting, I think there's a lot of people in there would have been delighted if they could have went home on Friday night and went on to the count centre and got the result within 5 minutes rather than having had two solid days at it so far, because yesterday was a big day as well as today. So it's time to come to a conclusion, hopefully.
Well, it was a tremendous feeling, very humbling, but also I think we have a sense that we have a job to do now. The result has come through. We have 5 years to work with the community groups and the business communities in a showing to try to address the historical imbalance in the area. So I think that's our project now. Move on from here.
Well, things are going quite well at this stage. It's been a remarkable achievement for the party overall, because it now looks as though we're going to achieve our goal of taking 4 out of the 6 seats here in Inishowen. And from the outset, I was confident of my own result and that of my colleague Rina Donaghy, and indeed that of Dennis McGonigal. But the remarkable achievement here today is the fact that Mary MacDonald is going to take the 4th seat here, and that's 4 out of 6 seats. It's a gain for Fianna Fáil during a time when a government's in mid-term and where there's a perceived backlash and a rise in support for the likes of Sinn Féin. It's, as far as I'm concerned, a great day for the party here in Inishowen. And I'm looking forward now to 5 years with a strong team here delivering on the ground, and really it is a reflection of the hard work and dedication of a whole Fianna Fáil organisation that swung into action in this election and delivered the vote.
Motor tax, always one of those things that for most of us is a hassle to take care of. Not anymore. Call into your new local offices on Blaney Road, Letterkenny, Mallon Road, Carndonagh, Main Street, Milford and Gador Road, Dunlow. You can apply for planning permissions, pay bills, request housing repairs, find out everything you need to know about council services and services provided by the state, for example the Health Board or Department of Social and Family Affairs. Your local council office is closer than you think. Call in and get to know us. Ireland's Northwest, well known for its traditional Irish welcome and the warmth of its people, invite you to sample the best in Irish holidays. Cavan, Donegal, Leitrim, Monaghan and Sligo offer week-long, weekend and midweek breaks with leisure activities, festivals and a vibrant nightlife to suit all tastes and budgets. It's an ideal holiday destination.
Ireland's Northwest. Great value for money, just waiting to be discovered.
The following is the result of count one. Alice Bonner, Bina Foyle, 2,963, 2,063. Peter Carlin, 800, 800. Tom Dignam, Sinn Féin, 1,916, 1,016. Martin Michael Harley, Fine Gael, 686, 686. Patrick McGowan, Fianna Fáil, 1,489, 1,489. J.J. Reid, Fine Gael, 1,126, 1,126. As the votes of Alice Bonner exceed the quota, I deem her to be elected.
Oh, Naomi, it's fantastic. It's fabulous to get back in to take a seat in Donegal County Council. It's a fantastic honour. But to top the poll and to be a woman atop the poll is absolutely fabulous, brilliant. I think, to be honest, that both Patty and myself for the party, we've worked exceptionally hard on the ground in the 5 years in the whole area, and people acknowledge that to us. And the both of us have got here, it proves that today, so it has. We were local representatives. We attended the meetings. We did the work, no matter whatever time, 24/7. We worked around the clock, like, and whether it was a Sunday meeting or a Saturday meeting or whatever was wrong, we were there for the people, and that's what people wanted: local representation. There's no point working. You can't work 9 to 5, 5 days a week. It's 7 days a week. You must be willing to make the commitment, and we've done that. And certainly, the people have done us proud with our result here.
We've had a tough campaign. Obviously, in my own electoral area, we have 4 out of 6. It looks like we're going to have 4 out of 6 again. We still kept a very good vote. In the Finn Valley, we've increased our percentage vote. In the Milford electoral area, we're struggling, certainly, but an independent who was former Fianna Fáil is doing very well. The Glenties electoral area, we have a gain of a third seat. And in Letterkenny, we're neck and neck to maybe get another gain. So overall, Donegal has done very well for Fianna Fáil.
Going very well. We're just waiting now for the first count to come in, and I'll be top of the poll, and with a circle of probably about 350 votes to be transferred, so delighted, very happy. The campaign was very good. We've canvassing hard for the last 6 weeks and that there, and towards the end, in the last couple of days, everybody was on a buzz and a good high and that there, so the feeling was there that things were going to go very well.
Constant pressure all the time, and I think that's the only way to achieve your goal. You know, you keep harping and harping away, and as the old saying always goes, you know, the crying wains always fed the first. I'm really very, very happy today with the turnout and the achievements for Donegal Town.
Turning to the Glenties electoral area, again, Fianna Fáil, they went with 2 seats the last time out of a possible 6. This time it looks like they're going to have 3. The former Senator Enda Bonner looks like he's going to be home and dry. Outgoing chairperson of the council, David Alcorn, will also make it, while Brian O'Donnell of Gort the Herc is going to top the poll. Extremely strong performance from Brian O'Donnell. Then Fine Gael's Terence Slowey looks like he's set to return to the council chamber, and there are a number of other candidates vying for the last seats. Again, it's going to be exciting in Glenties.
Well, I'm extremely appreciative of the huge vote that I got, the first preference vote of 2,318. I'd like to first of all thank all those who supported me in getting that vote. And obviously I'm delighted from a party point of view. I'm also delighted because we're in line to win 3 seats, which would be a 50% increase on what we currently hold in the Glenties electoral area, that being, of course, 2 seats held by Councillor Enda Bonner and David Alcorn. It came across quite clearly that people were looking for youth, for invigorance, and that has been shown in the vote which I have received. And I think people actually appreciated the hard work that I have done over the last 4 years while being a board member of Uddaross and the Gaeltacht also. So I'm particularly pleased with my personal vote. I look forward to representing the people of the Glenties electoral area on Donegal County Council, and That will be a challenge which I look forward to meeting.
We don't accept the wages that we receive from MEPs or from Leinster House. You know, we accept the average industrial wage, and people respond to that there. They know that we're not in there for, you know, our own interests. We're not in there for to line our own pockets. We're in there because we're working with the communities. We know the demands of the communities, and we want to deliver the change that these communities are demanding. So, you know, people are seeing that there. They're seeing that we're not the same as, you know, the Gombian politics, the clientelism politics that have been practiced in the past. And that's why more and more people are voting Sinn Féin, because of our role in the peace process, because of our role in local communities, and because of the different style of politics that we offer.
I'm particularly pleased as the chairman of the council, because I know in a couple of counties of people who have worked very hard and outgoing Kyrenes who have lost their seats. But I'm glad and very, very proud, and I've no doubt at this stage that on the 25th of June, when the new council comes together for the first time, that I'll still be the leader of the House, and I'm exceptionally pleased for that, and I look forward to welcoming in the other 28 councillors. Again, of course, that's pending me being elected here this evening, but I have no doubt on the on this surplus and the votes of my local candidates, Seamus Rogers and John Green and Thomas McDyer, people like that are eliminated, that I'm very hopeful of reaching the quota at that stage.
Desi Larkin of Independent Fianna Fáil polled very well, in fact topped the first preference and was the first elected. No surprise that Gerry Crawford and Kieran Brogan of Fianna Fáil were going to be elected, and Jimmy Hart of Fine Gael would be returned, so it's no surprise that those four. The question in the Letterkenny area was always going to be who would take that fifth seat. I mean, in the build-up to the election, the re-entrance of Jim Devaney to politics suggested that maybe he felt he had a chance of taking it. Tony McDade of Sinn Féin, given their strong performance both at local and national level, was always going to be there. And then the other Fianna Fáil candidate, young Damien Blake, who was running both the Letterkenny Urban and the Letterkenny County Council area, was going to be in with a chance. That's the way it's really panned out.
Blake Damien, plus 41, giving a total of 1,374. 1,374. Rogan Kieran, plus 56, giving him a total of 1,863, 1,863. Crawford Gerry, plus 280. If the vote of Gerry Crawford exceeds the quota, I deem him to be elected.
Well, it's been a long day from 9 o'clock this morning, but to be declared elected with a total that's pleasing and that's reflective of the the area, I'm very pleased at this stage and delighted. But again, it's a responsibility that we have to live up to now for the next 5 years again. On the canvas, I found that the people were receptive. Some people openly expressed their concerns and their disapproval of certain issues. But they were courteous, and overall, it was a very constructive canvas.
Topping the poll, I suppose, in Letterkenny Town Council, being elected first count, and now topping the poll and getting elected first in the Letterkenny electoral area, it's a great achievement, and I suppose it shows the work that we've done on the ground, independent Fianna Fáil, and the hard work all the people who've supported me here today have put in. And I suppose it's gratitude and for them, the fact that they can look and say, listen, people have recognised we're working hard, so it's been a brilliant 2 days. A little tiring because we went through the whole process, but more than happy with what we have achieved.
I mean, it's vitally important that Letterkenny has a strong voice within Donegal County Council to ensure that Letterkenny gets its fair share of the cake. I'm confident that I have the experience and the ability to bring those concerns to the Chamber in Lifford. I think it's vitally important that there's a link between the Letterkenny Town Council and Donegal County Council to ensure that we can work together. And I'm confident again that I can play a part in that and ensuring that Letterkenny gets its fair share. Letterkenny has achieved a lot in the last 5 years, but it's vitally important that we continue to develop, and it's vitally important there's much more to do in Letterkenny, a lot of investment, a lot of infrastructure, and I'm quite sure that I can assure the people of Letterkenny that voted for me, regardless of whatever preference, that I'll bring them their issues to the council chamber.
Well, I think like most councils re-elected, you have to work on the ground for the 5 years after your last election, and I think I put in a fair amount of work locally, and I have a base in Letterkenny, and a base in the country as well, where I have an office in Rafo. So I've worked hard at it, and along with other people, and I think just the surge maybe for Fine Gael in this last few weeks has helped as well.
The Milford one, well, we're going to a recount there, and that's been a dramatic day, really. Liam Blaney was always going to take a seat for Independent Fianna Fáil. He was co-opted last year in place of Niall. He's polled very strongly, as expected. It's Blaney country, Milford, so there was never any question of that. There was, again, going to be a Fine Gael seat. Noel McBride appeared to be the favourite ahead of Tommy Ryan, his running mate. That's the way that's turned out. And again, the big question mark was who would fill the third seat. Could Fianna Fáil maintain it? Noel McGinley had stepped out of politics. Hugh McDade was the candidate. Or could somebody else come to the fore? Ian McGarvey, the surprise package. Been around politics for a long time, but I don't think anyone could have anticipated the first preference votes that he achieved, something like 1,200. It's gone to the wire. At the end of the vote, he's three votes ahead of Hughie McDade. Not surprisingly, Hughie McDade's asked for a recount, but I'd hate to be the person who'd have to call it, although I'd have to say Gary Martin and his team did a fantastic job here.
Well, following on from the completion of the count here last night, we were asked to have a recount, and we started that recount at 10 o'clock this morning. Effectively, we're going through all of the individual ballot papers that were counted yesterday, from the first preferences onwards, checking to see if there's any discrepancies or errors that would have taken place. We'll be doing that in respect of every single ballot paper, some 9,300 odd of those. And once we complete that, hopefully sometime by the middle of the afternoon, we will be looking to see if that makes a material difference to the final result.
I'd be a success on the hard work of all the independent Fianna Fáil candidates down through the years. Niall before me, my father, my uncle, and the whole independent Fianna Fáil party. With three candidates in the Milford area, those 10 candidates overall, fighting for three seats. It was dubbed the grip of death day one, which was going to be very hard to get out of it. We'd hoped to get two candidates elected out of the three, but it didn't materialise. But I think with the many candidates was in it and the hard work that our party put in, that I topped the poll and that the other two candidates got a good enough vote as well.
Today is a retirement day for me, but I'm absolutely delighted that after running a strategy of two very strong candidates in my own area, I've held on to my seat. We've held on to our vote. Our supporters are delighted, but also there's a losing candidate as well. So we feel for Tommy Ryan today, but we're delighted that Noel McBride held the seat.
Our campaign was based on what we delivered to the Milford electorate area over the past 5 years. We felt that we had delivered enough to retain Noel McGinley's seat, which he held for over 33 years. Obviously, the people of Milford electorate didn't think that. We thought we had delivered, as I say, so they decided that they wanted more.
Way back in the early years, even before I was on the council, but I was an activist in the party, everyone was party. And you had the leaders of the parties at that time telling us that, you couldn't cross vote. That if there were three Fianna Fáil candidates, it had to be 1, 2, 3. If there was three Fine Gael candidates, it had to be 1, 2, 3. And anything else, was a spoiled vote. I think the electorate has got very intelligent, thanks to Fianna Fáil's free education. And they now know that they might vote Fianna Fáil 1 and Fine Gael 2 and Sinn Féin 3.
That's all from Election Coverage 2004. May we take this opportunity to thank everybody who helped make this programme. And we wish the newly elected councillors good luck. Thank you for watching.